Like this.
It's not just saying it.
Bob, please. I know I've not been repaying back my loans, but this will be the last time. You just have to bail me out, please.
How much?
My transportation to and fro with this man. 7.5 and my people, they shouldn't get anything from me because I'm not working. 10,000 naira.
10 what?
10,000.
I don't have it.
Bob, please, please, please. I just need this money. Please, you just have to bail me out. It's the minimum amount I need to travel with. Please.
And you come home with this miserable loaf of bread.
Please.
Please. Please, what, Leonard?
I know that I have...
What do you know? Leonard. What do you know, Akalogole? You left with promises of taking over the mantle. After years of borrowing and starving, disappear into thin air.
Papa, please, your health does not permit you to...
Health? Did you say my health? Leonard, what do you care about my health? What do you care if I lived or died? If Ichie Ikego hadn't died, and the headmaster searched and dragged you home, Leonard, would you have seen your father alive? Answer me.
Papa, please, it's not the way you see it. The way you see it, Papa.
What is the way? Which way am I supposed to see it, Leonard? Mother Leonard, she has aged considerably. Leonard, your mother has been overworking herself because she has to keep pace from where you should have long since taken over. Me, Leonard, my health is failing, Leonard, this cough is eating me gradually, my waist, I can barely support. The doctors, they warn me that if I do not stop this ailment, if I do not stem this ailment, I will not live to see the next 5 years.
The doctor said that. Mama, is it true?
See, Janet, look at your sister. Leonard, your sister Janet, her husband died a year ago.
What?
Yes.
Janet! Why didn't anybody tell me now?
Yeah.
Janet!
Here, my son. Here, your brother. How could anyone have told you? How? When no one knew your whereabouts, Leonard. Huh? Yes, Janet. Janet is living with us, with our two children. The mother-in-law accused her of killing him.
Huh.
For 6 months, they have been living with us. As if that is not enough, Monica had a slight quarrel with her husband. There is no hope of mending that quarrel, Leonard. For 3 months, Monica has been living here with her two children.
Leonard, take it easy. Take it easy because of your health.
How can I take it easy? How can I take it easy when your son has decided to send me to an early grave?
Papa, how can you say a thing like this now? Papa, how can you say this?
Your younger ones. Okuchuku and a boy. Leonard. They are now laborers. They now follow masons and carpenters as apprentices.
What?
Obianuju and Nkechi. They are now farmers. They now follow their mother to the farm every day.
God, why has the world's entire problems
decided to wage war on this house. God!
It's all your fault. It is all your fault. All our hopes, all our eggs were in your one basket. What a wasted aspiration. The elders are not here yet. Yes, they have gone to Chiekegos to prepare for his burial. Wait until they finish tomorrow.
What do they want? Yes, what do they want from us?
See.
Papa.
Let me help you. Let me help you.
Brother, take it easy. I'm tired of all the sad girls I'm doing in the village. I need to go to school.
Brother, look at my hands. Look at my hands. We had to follow Mama every day to the farm. Before the hot sun and the heat. I'm tired. And if we don't go, I simply nothing to eat. No food. Nothing to eat!
Brother, where I'm learning carpentry, my master has warned me not to come tomorrow without my apprenticeship fee.
Janet, what happened to your husband now?
He was poisoned.
Headmaster here have told you that many people who borrowed or sold whatever they had to train in school have all died without realizing an iota of benefit for all their huge investment.
Did they tell you?
Answer!
My fathers, it is enough torture within me to note that I have failed this community. But to remind me is something that could further tear me to shreds.
No, Leonard! No! That is not what we are after. What we are saying, in effect, is that we can no longer allow you to start paying. Reasons being that you are stupid, irresponsible, callous. You are not a true son of this community.
Yeah.
And above all, it is evident, nothing good will ever come out of you.
Elders, please, elders, it hasn't come to...
Hey, Headmaster,
don't put your mouth. It has come to everything. Everything! After us, we are the person who put us into this trouble.
Yes. I should.
Just give me a minute.
Please, my elders, I beg of you, please. Just give me a little more time. Please.
Leonard, you were given 4 years and nothing.
Nothing.
What do you think you can possibly do, even if you are given 40 years more?
Masike, sit down. Hey, sit down. I said, sit. Masike, keep quiet and sit down. Leonard, you have 6 months. 6 months to pay back every copper that was spent in training you, or else we will descend on your father's land and every property in it. Do you hear me? 6 months. Is that not so?
That's it.
Mom, let us go.
You have to stay here and listen to me.
No, 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 leave
me.
Let us go.
Please, please.
6 months or else.
Please. My elders, please, please. Please. My elders, please.
Please, sir. Please. I know I have failed. I have failed my father. I have failed my family. What's most painfully, sir, I know I have failed you. Sir, please. I'm very sorry for all the insults you received here today. Please. Sir, please, just give me another chance. Please.
Chance?
Yes, sir.
What chance?
I'm sorry.
Leonard.
Papa.
Leonard.
Papa, please. Papa, look at me. Papa, please. I'm sorry. Papa, I have failed, I know, but things will get better. Things will get better, Papa. Papa, please.
Bob, please. Leo, what's going on here? Please get up, you're embarrassing me, what's this?
Not as much as I've embarrassed myself. Please.
What is it? Just get up.
Bob, I just need some money. Just a little amount to get me started. And this time is the last, please.
Listen to yourself, Leo, listen to yourself. How many times have I heard this word, it's going to be your last time?
Bob, this time is for real. Please.
Do you realize, Leo, that by my calculation, you owe me 285,000 naira? Money you don't even have a hope of paying back.
Bob, how can you say a thing like
how
that?
How can I say something like that? Tell me. Convince me why I should not talk to you like that. When do you even lose a job before you find one?
Bob, you know it's not my fault.
Yes, it is my fault. No, tell me, whose fault is it then? Have you ever asked yourself, the money that you've been borrowing from me, how do I make it? Have you asked yourself that?
Well, I know you have friends and you know your way around town.
Friends? No. Know my way around? Yes. But let me tell you something. I earn every kobo I spend. Do you understand me? Every bit of it, I earned it. I work for it.
You don't work.
Thank you.
I don't know any establishment you work for.
Good.
So, how?
Have you asked yourself what I do all night when I say to you I go night browsing?
I did ask you once and you said you were surfing for universities abroad.
And you believe me?
Why would I to the contrary?
Well, now you know.
Know what?
That I do the re-browsing. I mean the main thing.
Bob, what are you talking about?
Problems, yeah?
See you later, yeah?
Sites all night. But you see here, this is where the saints feast.
This is when we do pre-business.
What kind of business?
That's where most real money come from. Crime.
What? Yes.
Boom! So you mean you've been stealing on the internet?
I won't put it as in that way.
Communities provide mineral that the politicians feed fat on.
It's God's world and not the politicians' world.
Forget it. Politicians reap the populace every other time.
But, I mean,
what is
but?
No, explain to me. Leo, explain to me why the best brain this country has ever produced could not even find himself employment for the past 5 years. Talk more about feeding himself. Meanwhile, fools go around driving and cruising around with Hummer jeeps.
There's time for everything.
There is time for everything. And that time is why your father is dying of tuberculosis back home. Leo, how long will it take you to wake up to reality? How long will you be trampled upon for you to wake up? Answer me. Leo na dike di namba. Saints don't dwell here anymore. You are plying on lonely road. Lonely road, you're on that track alone. Wake up!
So?
So what I'm saying is, join me. Join the bandwagon, make money. Make yourself survive. Make your family proud. Make your entire community at large proud for you at for once. And at least, make yourself comfortable. That is all this world is all about. Live fast, live well, and enjoy it while it lasts. Okay? And the internet, and with your kind of brain, it will not take you more than 1 month to know the world around us.
And after that,
you join the bandwagon
to perpetrate fraud.
The choice is yours, either to perpetrate fraud or whatever, but the choice is yours, either to watch your family die one after the other, starting from your father, and after that watch your community take over your land.
I can't live to allow that.
Well, it's not all about words. You hear me? It's not all about words. You have to put action, act, do something. Do you understand? It's in your hand to survive. Got to hack informations once he keep in the right words. I bought it $5,000, but it's worth a million times over.
So what do I work on? I mean, what do I hack?
Credit cards.
Credit cards?
Yeah.
And how do I use it? No one uses credit cards around here.
The world is a global village. Yeah? I'm talking about the American credit cards. And the dollars is internationally accepted all over the world.
I still don't get it.
You use it to shop online, make purchases. I mean, shop, purchase, anything.
Purchases?
Sure.
Purchases like what?
Anything, name it, cars, clothes, hardwares, all sorts.
Wait a minute. Don't tell me that these credit cards actually have enough money in them to make such big purchases.
Sure. My friend John hit $250,000 the other time.
You can't be serious.
I'm dead serious, my brother. And you know what? He ordered for himself 2 home images, computer hardware, some other things, and he shipped all of them back to Nigeria here.
That's foolishness now.
Foolishness? Leo, did I hear you say foolish? Are you saying a man who made $250,000 without breaking a sweat is foolish?
Of course he's foolish.
How?
Because if he wasn't foolish,
yeah,
he wouldn't buy those big things. Okay, he would have bought smaller things. Okay, smaller things with value. I'm talking about things that are not bulky. Okay, he would have bought gold, diamonds, jewelry. You know, smaller things. Things that are not bulky that could easily be transferred to cash. So he is foolish.
You've got a point there. Yeah, you sure have a brain of a genius, do you know that?
Give me 5 and put a smile to that face. Alright, let's get back to work.
What has he brought for us? Food. Hey, God, I thank you. God, I thank you. Hey, yeah. Madam, oh, thank you. Oh. Mommy. Mommy.
It's a miracle. That Leo brought food and money to his parents is a miracle?
Headmaster, for the first time. Headmaster, for the first time in 5 years.
Papa Leo, I had told you before that your son is a great man. Only for most great men, it takes time for things to work out easy for them. I only hope to God that this is the beginning of the end of his sorrows.
Headmaster!
It's all right, it's all right.
I am well now. I am well now.
It's all right. Master,
I am going for a meeting.
Hey, what's up, Bobby? How's it?
It was fine. And Bob, I thank you.
For what?
Even though it's not my line, I thank you. You see, things have started picking up. Today I was able to send 100,000 naira to my parents, so that my sisters can stop farming and my brothers can go back to school.
That's good.
But you see, my conscience is still shouting at me.
Mr. Conscience. Well, I don't blame you. Because you've just started lending a helping hand to your dying family at home. That's why you now have a conscience.
Oh. What do you mean?
Exactly what you heard. I want you to search that conscience of yours very well. If you really did have a conscience, you wouldn't have waited this long to help your family. Do you know if you had come to armed robbery, you would have been the first to go rob to save your family? Mr. Conscience, my foot. Interested.
Bob, you have to be interested. You have to be. Because if you are, you know the danger we run.
What danger are you talking about?
Internet hacking, as involving bank transfer, now attracts a death penalty. The Senate passed the bill yesterday.
So what?
So what?
Yeah?
It seems you don't know the meaning of death penalty.
Do we equally know that armed robbery in this country is a capital offense, punishable by death? Yet people still rob every day with guns.
Look, we just have to quit.
Quit?
Yes. I mean, let's find another trade. Nothing is worth dying for, please.
I understand how you feel. But let me tell you something. It's a person who gets caught that is a criminal.
Look, it's not all about getting caught, okay? When one commits a crime, caught or not, he becomes a criminal. I wasn't trained to become one.
Good. But if you let your parents die back home out of malnutrition, that is a moral crime, punishable by death via total extinction.
My conscience.
Relax on this, your conscience, please.
Bob, you know me. You know me. When I put my hands into something, I get to the tail end of it. I do it too well.
But I know.
I've gone a step ahead in this internet hacking thing.
I trust you're going to get there because you got the brains.
But this death penalty thing...
Forget it. Forget it. Like I said before, it's only the man that gets caught that is a criminal.
Enjoy it.
Last night,
yeah,
I broke into the central bank's secret transfer code.
What?
Relax now.
Go, get that. Go. Yo, this is solid code, you know.
Not with a death penalty hanging loose, Bob.
Leo, let's talk about the money first and deal with the death penalty later.
Bob,
yeah.
Defrauding the central bank, there's a 90 to 10% chance of getting caught.
I know. But a 10% chance of escaping is enough for us to grab the money if it's there at all.
It's there, all right.
So let's grab it. What are we waiting for?
This list here,
yeah,
are central bank transfer models. Any order I give right now,
yeah,
will get carried out to the letter.
So, let's go. Go.
Relax. Now, I want you to know that we are in this 50-50.
Of course, trust me.
And secondly, we are about stealing a governor's fund, which is obviously stolen.
Leo. Listen to me. Nothing on earth is going to make me as happy as this.
And thirdly, this will be the last time of my coming here. Bob, you know me. You know I'm not a fraudulent person. You know this is not
my line. Leo, it's okay. Okay, let's just hope so, yeah? Whatever, let's just get done with this and get out of here.
I will not do fraud again.
Okay. Let's do this one now. Please, sit down.
Bob, we are about transferring $100 million to a numbered account in Zurich.
$100 million? So what are we waiting for? Let's go ahead then. Come on, sit down. You sit down. Let's go. Go ahead.
But
now?
At the press of this button, I succeed. My family and my entire community will know no suffering.
So what are we waiting for? Go ahead and click the damn button, man. Go ahead. Let's do this and get out of here, man. Go on. Please. You genius! You won! You're great! Yes! What a bitch! Let's go! Close it up! I knew you were going to make it! How are you something else?
here when we're moving into this place that this place is just for a start. It's for management! Brother, with $100 million in our coffers, this place is obviously a hut. A garage! Hey! Have a glass, let's celebrate. You know what? You are a genius. So tell me, where do we go from here now?
Well, nothing more. We'll just get the money transferred into two separate accounts.
Okay.
And that's agreed 50-50.
I don't have a problem with you. That's okay. So when do we do it? Today, when?
No. We give it a week to mature.
Okay.
But seriously, I'm having this funny feeling. I will not go back to that cyber cafe.
Why? Oh, whoa. Listen. If it's about security, you don't have a problem. Yeah? I've been dealing with that cyber cafe a long time before now. See, they sort out everybody that's concerned. Both the EFCC, the police, just name it. They settle well-lamely, okay? Relax, let's celebrate.
Let's celebrate, man. Let's celebrate. It's good to have money. Jesus Christ, I can't believe this is real.
Hey! I feel you! Oh la la! Brother, to our wealth. It's more good things to come. The world look at us, we're coming. This is just the beginning. I am drinking champagne. Hey!
See the code I gave you?
Yeah.
Huh? You keep it in your head. Right? That's for your own $50 million.
Okay.
Alright?
Okay.
You will not write it anywhere. Just keep it in your head.
Okay?
Okay. I have mine.
So everything is done?
It's done. It's done.
Shut down, let's go.
Okay, let me sign off.
I'm his lawyer, for God's sake.
In that case, you should know better. He is remanded here under court order.
Just get out, let me do my job. Get out.
Just 10 minutes.
What the hell do you think you did in court, AL?
What did I do?
Admitting guilty without my consent in a case you hired me to handle?
Did I hire you? My friend, I know you're only after a percentage of the $50 million. And secondly, I'm guilty. Or am I not?
Do you know the implications of pleading guilty?
What are the implications?
Straight to the rooms, damn it, and solve it! Are you out of your mind?
Perhaps.
Don't sound like this. I came here to help you. Everyone out there steals from state funds and still come back to strut around in decadent impunity. Don't go into an open confession that would hang you while the big rogues in government sit in the front pews of churches and mosques.
But I already did.
That was during a mere mention. The trials have not begun. We can mend the damage when next you appear in court. But I beg you of one thing. Keep your traps shut until I tell you to open them when next you stand in that witness box. Is that clear?
You really want to help.
So why do you think I'm here?
Good. Then, Mr. Barrister, you go to my village. There's a headmaster there. A good man. My mentor. A man of God. The only hope I know that is still standing. You find him and bring him to me.
Would you stop? You know I cannot do this thing.
Sir, if you do not do this, you have failed me. You have not only failed me, you have failed my father. You have failed my family. And you have failed the community in which you have lived for 30 years now. Don't brood so much about me, sir. I'm only dying for tomorrow. It's the only option. The only honorable route left in the face of the challenges facing me now, sir.
What about your accomplice? Where is he?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Yes, I was just on my way going when I saw a friend of mine coming into this place. His name is
Bob.
Yes, exactly, Bob. It's been long. It's been long. Bob. Long time. Bob, it's me. Can't you remember? It's me.
I don't know you.
Bob, just try. You try. You remember?
Are you sure you're not mistaken?
Exactly. No, Bob, me.
No, don't.
We are special squad of the EFCC.
So.
Both of you are under arrest.
For what?
We have enough evidence that both of you are into internet hacking.
Are you sure?
You're under arrest. Take that! Stop! Let's go. Move.
Yes, good afternoon. It's me, the headmaster. Any hope?
Well, sir, I wouldn't say that there is a lot of hope. But at the same time, I would not say that the situation is entirely hopeless. At this moment, it boils down to prayers.
I see. It's all right. I'll be coming over tomorrow. Wherever God is now, he must take a vacation and concentrate on this matter before us.
Oh, I really hope he's listening, sir. Well, anyway, it's quite good you're coming around tomorrow because Leo has decided to pass on a very important information to you, sir. Please, sir, you should not fail to come around tomorrow.
It's all right. Thank you very much. But please, do everything in your power. He must be saved. He must be saved.
I'll do my very best. Organize this.
Sir, this young man is just a small fish in a pool of sharks. He cornered a mere negligible percent of The governor stole in funds because he was frustrated to the bulls.
Barrister Mecca, you know as much as I do that frustration is no excuse for crime. What I use in any case before me is criminal code, not sentiments or hypotheses.
But my lord, what happens to the governor who was about to transfer stolen state funds worth over $200 million before my client was able to corner a mere $100 million, of which $50 million cannot even be traced because the police killed his colleague, his partner in crime?
Bring your proof, and I will hang the governor.
It's all right, my lord. You'll have your proof very soon.
In the meantime, that doesn't mean your client is innocent.
We'll see to that very soon.
You just have 7 days to the judgment day.
I know that very well, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you very much. Have a good night, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, I've tried everything possible, but the governor wouldn't see me.
You must do something, barrister. Leo must not die. His death will kill his father and the family members he's been protecting. He calls it dying for tomorrow. There is not a dying for under these circumstances.
I understand your plight, sir. But I assure you, I'm actually doing my very best. I'm doing my very best.
This is my judgment. Frustration as a result of leadership action or inaction in providing the needed social security and basic amenities to our thinning youths of this country, notwithstanding, should not and can never be accepted as an excuse for committing crime. That is the message I am sending forth to our teeming youths of this nation as I deliver my judgment on this rather very pathetic case before me today. The accused, Mr. Leonard, and his defense counsel have sprouted up enough sentiments to have tempted me. But the law is not all about sentiments and emotions. It is all about facts, written laws, and strict adherence to them. On the strength of the evidence before me and my oath of allegiance to defend and uphold the laws of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, I find the accused guilty as charged. And I hereby sentence him to death by hanging. May God have mercy on his soul.
As the God of this,
I arise.
God!
His tender hands of innocence from the crooked paths of poverty. I searched for food and drank bitter water. Oh, with tender hands of innocence from the crooked paths of poverty. I searched for food and drank bitter water. Through stony paths and endless sweat, I traveled to toil under sun and rain. But all I reaped was emptiness. Through the stony paths and endless sweat, I traveled to toil under sun and rain. But all I reaped was emptiness.
If I could live this life again, thank you.
Can't you understand? You are not on invitation, so you can't enter here.
What nonsense are you talking about? I hear that His Excellency is having a function here and I insist on seeing him.
Listen, for the past 6 months, I have been trying to get across to His Excellency, all to no avail. I want to bring to his notice the case of a young man who was sentenced to death this morning because he stole 70% of what he, the governor, stole from the state.
Hey, Mr. Barrister, are you in your right senses?
I have never been more in my senses. Please tell His Excellency that should the hangman's noose tighten around that young man's neck, I will go public with every dirty detail of his transfer of funds via the central bank into the Swiss bank.
Do you know the implication of this wealth you're uttering? And in your own interest, I would advise you to get out of this premises now, before I do.
Please remember to tell His Excellency that I have got photocopies of all the evidence I have. All newspaper editors in this country have a copy each. The State Commissioner of Police has a copy. The Inspector General of Police has a copy. And as I'm talking to you now, a copy is on its way to the presidency. All to be opened in the event that something happens to that young man, or to myself for that matter.
Aren't you bluffing?
Please, call my bluff and make my day. But before you do that, remember to pass on my message to His Excellency.
The business!
You don't have to be in court to influence the judgment, Your Excellency.
So, what do you want from me now?
Presidential pardon for my client, Your Excellency.
Barrister Nika, how do you think I could swing that?
I wouldn't be here if I thought you couldn't swing that, Your Excellency.
What about my money that he stole?
With all due respect, Your Excellency, you and I know that those were state funds.
of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May God have mercy on your soul. Amen. May God have mercy on your soul. Amen. May God have mercy on your soul. Amen. Oh Heavenly Father, please grant him eternal rest in your bosom through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Drunk bitter water, always
tender hands of innocence from the crooked paths of poverty. I searched for food and drank bitter water, through stony paths and endless sweat. I traveled to toil on the southern rain, but all I read was emptiness. Through the stony paths and endless sweat, I traveled to toil on the sun and rain, but all I read was emptiness. Today there is no gain trying hard, so I die today for tomorrow. There is so much pain trying to live for today. There is no gain trying hard, so I die today for tomorrow. Trying to live for today. There is no gain in trying hard.